outside of Phoenix, Arizona, is a sleepy little town called Apache Junction. Now, what makes Apache Junction unique is the fact that that is the location of probably one of the greatest tales that's ever been told. And you might ask yourself, what the hell's the greatest tales ever been told? Well, how about the Lost Dutchman gold? You know, everybody knows the story. I don't care where you're from, you've heard the tale of the Lost Dutchman's gold. And that occurred in a place called the Superstition Mountains. Now, that's pretty peculiar when you think about it in itself, the Superstition Mountains. And you know, they were named that by the people that lived there, because the people that lived there believed that that was the gateway to hell, and that that was the land of the thunder gods. They believed that when that hot air blew through those canyons, it was actually coming from the portals of hell. And some people even believe that Jacob Waltz, the Lost Dutchman, actually found that portal and stole the devil's gold. Well, we're not sure about all that, but what we're sure of is the history. Hundreds of people have lost their lives in that mountain range. Every year, people need to get rescued off that mountain from heat. It's unbelievable the amount of deaths that's happened in that location. And what we're going to do is we're going to try to see if we can't dissect a little bit of that and figure out what the false from the truth is. And you're not going to want to miss this, because this tale is intriguing. Come along as we hunt down the Lost Dutchman's gold. So you've decided that you want to hunt the Lost Dutchman's gold.
So do you know what it's going to take to do it?
You know, are you prepared? Have you done a lot of hiking?
Are you physically ready to take this challenge on?
You know, because one thing that most people don't realize is you're going to bust your ass out here.
So if you're prepared and you're committed.
And maybe you're not committed. So if you can come along with us then. And so you won't have to get prepared. But if you do want to come hike with us, here's what you're going to have to do.
So we're going to talk preparation, research, and equipment.
You know, and you might even have to have a big set of balls. Did I just say that, James?
You did.
Well.
Even if you don't, give it a shot.
Damn.
Three.
So what is the Lost Dutchman, and what do you know about the legend of the Lost Dutchman's gold?
I think it's important to start with knowing what the legend is. I am in the boat that it is mythical, legend, not real.
So let me get this straight, James. What you're saying is you think it's bullshit.
Yes, bullshit would be the best description for me. Although I am looking forward to being able to go hike the Superstitions a lot while you try to find Lost Dutchman's gold.
Well, see, I just believe, though, James, that what you got to have, though, is you got to believe. Because if you don't believe, then how are you going to find it?
That is a very good point. I'm still going to stick in as the skeptic here, and I'm just going to enjoy the scenery. But I hope we find it, because that would sure make this whole thing a lot easier, you know, in the future.
So what we've got is we've got James, who is a naysayer, a non-believer, and we got me that... You gotta believe, man. If you're gonna do this, how can you go out day after day, hike 20 miles through thickets and bullshit if you don't believe?
I think I'm just as crazy as the believers, because I do that stuff for fun.
You know, I don't have a point counterpoint to that, James. I just had to believe that you're just another lunatic on the mountain.
That's fair.
Okay. You know, one of the funniest things when we're out here, it still makes it unique to me, is you think you're in the middle of nowhere and then you hear a jet. But just regardless of that jet, doesn't really matter, because you're still in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, no one up there is going to come down and find you.
Ain't nobody going to save you out here at all, is there?
I mean, it's very unlikely that if you get into some of the places we're going to be going, they're going to find you.
So the preparation is most important, right?
Yes.
And you say number one preparation thing we got to do is what?
The research, because we got to know where we're going to be going. Second is physical.
You know, the physicality, I'm not in the same shape I was in earlier with some of the issues I've had with my feet, but I'm getting back. And that's probably going to be a problem with me somewhere down the road. But, you know, out here, you just hike through it. There was a sign at the Grand Canyon that I loved, is that up or down is optional. Up is mandatory. So, you know, there's getting home is mandatory.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Not getting home is not an option, yeah. Right? So that's one of the most important things, is make sure that we're prepared and that we're safe and that we do these things right, because the reality of it is, you know, I don't want to have the goal by myself.
That's fair. The next would be equipment.
Right.
The next is what are you going to use? How are you? What kind of maps are you going to use? What kind of navigation are you going to use? Do we have a truck or a little car? If you have a little car, stay home.
Well, you know, one of the things too is there are limitations that the people don't realize. You can't mine out here anymore.
That's true, you too. Know. I was just going to say, like, you know, permitting, there's no prospecting, so you can't be cutting into the rocks.
But, you know, we're not looking for a mine that, you know, it was already dug. That doesn't mean it couldn't have been filled in, though. I mean, it really doesn't. It doesn't mean that, you know, you look at the mines even in the areas that we've seen that are already filled in. I mean, there definitely could be mines that are out here that are filled in that maybe you don't see, you know, that were hidden. And that's a possibility, because you got to look at two things, right? Are we looking for a cache or are we looking for a mine? And who knows that?
Well, that's the fun thing about all this, is that we're going to have to go through all of those different,
right?
All of those different potential possibilities. We're going to have to just chalk each and every one of them off if we're going to do this right.
Well, you know, and the funny thing is there's so much to learn, but you know, the opportunity is we also have the museum, Superstition Mountain Museum, right?
Yeah.
Who spent their life collecting all these stories, and hopefully we can work with them so we can get some of this history down.
Yeah.
You know,
and hopefully
we can.
Yeah,
you know, there's always these secrets out there though, right? I mean, I don't care who you are, there's always some guy that thinks he knows where the gold is that doesn't want to tell you. You know, there's always that plays into this, and there's always the shady people that,
well, being
know,
a skeptic part of this, I'm gonna say I would ignore all of those people, because all of the experts have been doing this for 100 years, and they had a TV show already about this, and they were all on it. And there aren't 200 millionaires.
You know, we'll start this series with this question. How's that? And I'll let you kind of answer what you think. You think the gold's been found?